Hi, this is Amy from the Altis store. Now, we've been doing a series of videos where we're showing wiring mismatched solar panels and what makes sense for wiring them in series, parallel, or just not even at all. So we've been putting together a playlist, and you can see that here, so you can watch through with some of the other examples we've given. So right now, what I've got is two 100-watt solar panels. One is a 24-volt nominal, and one is a 12-volt nominal. So what we're going to show is they're both going to go through an MPPT charge controller. So going into the battery, we're going to measure them each individually so we can confirm that what we're getting individually. Then we're going to wire them in series, and we're going to wire them in parallel. All right? So first we've got our 24-volt solar panel, and it is going through the MPPT charge controller, and it's going into my 12-volt battery. So I'm going to turn on the solar input, and I am getting, there we go, I've got 32.9 volts into the charge controller. I've got 12.9 volts at the battery coming out of the charge controller, and I have 5.69 amps going from the charge controller into the battery. Now keep in mind, this solar panel has got an IMP, a maximum power current of 2.78 amps. So it's putting in 2.78 amps into the charge controller, and it's coming out at 5.69. So that's because the MPPT charge controller is taking that high voltage, it's dropping it down, and then it's outputting the higher amperage with the lower voltage, retaining most of the power. So I'm just going to write this down, and then we're going to rewire it so that we're going to measure the 12-volt panel. All right, so now I've got my 12-volt solar panel, also 100-watt. So you can see I've got an input of about 20 volts, so my VMP is right around 18 volts, so it's actually doing quite well. It's really putting in a very high voltage. I've got perfect conditions here. And it's going through the MPPT charge controller, and it's outputting 4.42 amps. So that is compared to the 5.69 amps, and it's also right around 13.1 volts. So the IMP of the 12-volt panel is 5.56 amps, and I'm seeing 5.81 amps going in. So again, it's doing really well. I've got great conditions because it's dropping that voltage down. It is actually increasing that current a little bit. So that's one of the advantages of using an MPPT charge controller, is you can actually get a little bit better than IMP, or maximum power current, into the battery. So I'm going to now change this around and wire the two of them in series, and we'll see what we get with that. All right, so now I've got these two wired in series. So I have the plus from the 12-volt panel going to the charge controller, the minus going to the plus of the 24-volt panel, and then that minus coming into the charge controller. So they're wired in series, and I'm getting 43.8 volts going into the charge controller, which makes sense because that's the two of these added together, because wiring in series increases voltage. So now coming out, I'm getting 8.81 amps. I'm gonna write that down, 8.81 amps, because it's taking all of the current going in and it's increasing it, and as it's dropping that voltage down to the 13.4 volts. So now we're going to change it, and we're going to wire the two of them in parallel and see what we get for an output. Okay, so I have the 24-volt panel and the 12-volt panel wired in parallel. Now you see I've got 23 volts in. Now when I had that solar panel, the 24-volt solar panel by itself, it was measuring up around 40 volts, but because I've got it wired in parallel with this 12-volt panel that's putting out about 18 volts, it's pulling that voltage down. So it is dramatically reducing the voltage output of that solar panel. So just from what we see going in, we can see that it's very unhappy being wired in parallel with a lower voltage. So doing the series in, you saw that it had added the 2 volts and that was fine. So doing in parallel, we're pulling that down, we're greatly reducing it. My current output is about 7 amps. So we've got that lower voltage going in, but we're only around 7 amps coming out. And we were up in the upper 8 amps when we were wired in series. So you can see here that wiring 2 mismatched panels, if you've got mismatched voltages and you've got an MPPT charge controller, wire the 2 of them in series. Let the voltage go through, add up, and then the charge controller, being MPPT, can take that higher voltage and reduce it down. I hope this was helpful. If so, give us a like and a share, and be sure to subscribe to our Altea Store channel so we'll notify you when we've got more videos coming out. And don't forget to go to our alteastore.com website, where we've been making renewable doable since 1999.